Hey everybody, this is Ian Haugland.
And I'm Mick, and we're from the band Europe.
Don't forget to read Maximum Rock.
Exactly. Okay, so I'd like to start by asking you, you think that Romania has finally made it to the rock circuit? I mean, you guys have been here before, and I think you have a certain image of what's going on.
Well, it seems like this festival here is pretty much, you know, with big names and all, and it's, I mean, it's one hell of a job to pull a festival like this off. So it means that Romanian promoters know the drill, sort of. But I mean, it's, as you said before, it's, we've been here before playing, and it's a great audience to play here, especially when you're heading from, let's say, from Eastern Europe. Eastern Europe is always, it seems like the audience is always a bit more, you know, go for it, a bit more hectic, sort of appreciate it, than if you go and play in, say, England or Germany, places like that. Probably has to do a bit with the Western Europe is maybe a bit more spoiled with rock concerts and stuff like that.
But nowadays, it seems like it's all happening here now.
Really?
Yeah. I think so. It seems to me that like the eastern parts of Europe are really taking over rock and roll.
Yeah.
When it comes to festivals and things like that.
But I think it's good because it opens up a new market for us.
Yeah.
The second leg of the career.
But in general, I would say Romania has always been a great place for us to play.
Yeah. Very happy to hear that. Let's get to Europe right now. You've released a new record, Vagabones, right? And you work with this really cool producer, Kevin Shirley. I guess a lot of you know, rock fans know him with working with, for example, with Iron Maiden, stuff like that. How did it work out for you guys to work with him?
I think it was very cool.
Yeah, it was really cool. We met him a few months prior to recording the album, just to, you know, see if we
compatible.
Yeah, exactly. And it just clicked right away. So it was really smooth, and he likes to work kind of fast, which we liked a lot too. At least four of us, I think. But so it was really good for us. And I think, I mean, he taught us a few things about how he's doing. I think we maybe taught him a few things as well. It was kind of fun, you know. First, we really wanted to work in this old studio in Stockholm. And it's, I mean, everything, nothing has changed since the 70s, I guess. Except for some new Pro Tools recording and stuff. But I mean, all the boxes, everything, all the delays, it's all the same as it used to be. So, at first, when he and Kevin came, we went together to check the studio out, and when he got in the room, he was like looking around. Oh shit! How is this gonna work? But in the end, I think he really loved it. He really enjoyed the vibe in the studio, and so did we, of course. It was good fun. Good work.
Yeah, he was just one of the guys. You know, he wasn't. You know, he's the kind of guy that prefers to take a walk through the city than ride a limousine, you know.
Yeah.
So he's really a backpacker kind of guy.